y'all, welcome back to a brand new comic reaction. This time, issue 11 of The Amazing Spider-Man. It looks like we actually went back to the original artist that did like the first like five issues. So what was up with all those like four issues that were like had different artists on them? Was the other guy out sick? Was did Nick Spencer just feel like changing up? Or those all just were those issues just nonsensical filler that had no bearing on the plot, which I hope it wasn't, because that superhero support group thing that MJ went to, where we had like, I'm pretty sure Foggy was there, Daredevil, as well as I knew Gang was there. I really hope that's something that sticks around. Like maybe not a huge role here in the Spider-Man comic, but maybe like appears here and there in other comics, because that's actually a really nice idea that I thought Nick Spencer did a really good job. I liked it in Kimo. That's actually something really cool. I've really done the support group. I hope those other issues were nonsensical there, because there was also some nice stuff with Black Cat in there I liked. The stuff with MJ was amazing, and that shot when MJ was just super sassy towards Tony was perfection. Well, we got our man, J. Jonah Jameson. Get to work. Sigh. Every morning from 6 to 11 a.m., talk 616. Next page. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the old guy's back. This art style looks like his. Okay, let's see. Yep, Ryan's back. Lifetime Achievement, Part 1. With the Thieves Guild of New York temporarily subdued, so was that, like, what was the whole Thieves Guild arc? Was that nonsensical filler? I want to know why they swapped artists for those issues in particular. Why? Why? Was he out sick? Was he messing with other books? Was he like, man, I can't help you right now, get someone else? Like, why they switch artists? Someone please explain that to me, please. 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 Anyway, alright, let's read this quick little description. Thieves Guild of New York's temporarily subdued, and the rift of between him and Black Cat closes. You know, good. That was a nice little moment between Black Cat and Peter. I really dug it. Jimmy was like, took off his mask and shoved, like, hey, my name's Peter. So that was a nice little touch. I love that moment they had with them. While I'm always going to be an MJ shipper, I do love it when he's with Black Cat. It's always entertaining, those two. Okay, Peter Parker can relax and enjoy the holiday season as much as any unemployed young adult who also fights crime with his spider powers. Anyway, let's get ready for a relatively uneventful and have a good night. And also, guys, hold on, where's the box? Where did I put that box? Okay, found it. Check it out. Your boy got Venom. My mom already unboxed it when she came home with it, so I couldn't do an unboxing of it, but yeah. Venom. Love this movie. Saw the lead scenes. Very disappointing. The 40 minutes that were cut, they ain't in here. There's like only like one deleted scene this whole thing where it might have been part of the 40 minutes when they were in the truck where they were like, Eddie was getting like an Uber to the hospital. I think it might have been like when he was making his way to the hospital the first time to get the MRI scans, I think. And you know, he's like messing around with like the door window thing, and he's like, don't stop that, you're gonna break it. He says, he goes on saying like, you know, that he used to steal toys when he was a kid, not because he wanted to keep them. No, I didn't want to keep them. I just wanted to be the guy that found them and gave them back. And you know, he's like, he pretty much wanted to be like a superhero, which, you know, that's some decent character development. I don't know why that was cut. That scene was awesome, and also the banter between him and Venom was always entertaining. There was one about a car alarm that was rather pointless, and you can see why it was deleted. But, like, there's only three of them, and so it's better than Justice League, which only gave us two, and there were already shit we already knew. This was at least new shit, but... Yeah, and the third one, like, it was like an extended of the post-credit scene with Woody Harrelson as Cletus Cassidy. Woody Harrelson, I can definitely tell is gonna make a good Carnage in Venom 2. But I won't lie, Jake Gyllenhaal, they probably should have gotten Jake Gyllenhaal instead, especially if you have seen Nightcrawler, a movie that Jake Gyllenhaal starred in, you will know that he would make an amazing Cletus Cassidy. Amazingly, this cast. But Billy Harrison, they can tell you 69. I don't think the wig is that bad. Everybody's been like, this wig isn't that bad. Everyone says, like, this wig looks terrible. And I was like, eh, it looks fine to me. So, anyway. Alright. So, let's get with this Christmas issue of The Amazing Spider-Man. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas, as I'm here to burn it down. Rocking a Seth Rollins shirt. Anyway, let's get into it. Ah, Christmas in New York. What could be better? And it's a time for shut up. Oh, New York, the season of no, you shut up. Oh, New Yorkers, nothing but assholes. That is the joke. I've been in New York. They're not as bad as you see them in movies. Where like, I swear everyone is like an asshole. Anyway, when people from around the world come to celebrate, and you're an idiot. Oh, I love this guy. The children gather to hear stories of a jolly old man, his little, and his list. The list of Jericho? You listen to me, you nincompoop! I'm gonna tell you one more time! Oh, I love this shit. JJ! Raging ass podcast, just like in Spider-Man PS4. Hell yeah! Hell yeah! Spider-Man is a hero! Spider-Man is a hero, or my name's not J. Jonah Jameson! Wait, what? JJ doesn't hate Peter in this universe, or at least right now, he doesn't hate him? He's actually on his side? Not me! That's right, J. Jonah Jameson, former Pulse of the WW, and my old arch nemesis of sorts. We recently had a chance to. Oh yeah, change of relation. Oh yeah, they had like a dinner together. It was in Spectacular Spider-Man, I think. The cover had like this little like stain on Peter's suit. I think that was the one, because I remember people talking about that. So I think that might be the one that Daryl were talking about that conversation. I believe it was that one. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was that one. Anyway. Okay, when I revealed my secret identity to him over dinner, it really was a nice dinner. It did change everything, but it's been a blessing and a curse. Everyone in the city owes Spider-Man a tremendous debt. This feels so wrong. The JJ is always on the side of Peter. I like the Raimi suit, Spider-Man PS4. Seriously. I'm not even getting into that shit. I'm not even getting into that shit. I love you guys. Follow me on Twitter. You already know what I think about that shit. Links down in the description box below if you want to follow me on Twitter at KissMonster. Anyway, everybody in the city owns Spider-Man tremendous dad. You hear me? It's time to protect. It's time. People knew the facts. But you always said he was a threat and a menace. People are like, bro, you said he was a menace just 5 minutes ago! I always said, are you going to listen to what I'm saying or what I'm saying? How many times has he saved your ungrateful lives and all you people ever give him is grief? You gave him grief. Next caller. Yep, that's Jane Jonah's new song. J. Jonah Jameson, on the side of Peter Parker, a.k.a. Spider-Man. Song and dance. Another glorious morning drive with my desolate tones educating and informing the multitudes. Yeah, multitudes. I tell you, Buskin, I was born for this job. You certainly know how to talk. How to put the talk in the talk radio, Jonah. So he's doing a podcast or like a radio show now. Somebody's been playing Spider-Man PS4. I see you, Nick Spencer. I see you. It's just my natural charisma. You see how I've gotten the audience eating out of the palm of my hand? Yes, which reminds me, we should talk about the ratings. The ratings are shit, aren't they? Yep. No need. Last I checked, they were through the roof. People can't get enough of my no-holds-barred straight talk. And it's a good thing that that commitment to the new to the truth is needed now. Now more than ever, what would this crook Wilson Fisk to need in the mayor's office? Oh, that reminds me. This came for you. The Century Club, why haven't I been back there since they revoked my membership? I am not a day goes by whereby I don't miss that complimentary lunch buffet. What do you want? What do they want? It's a bill? No, it's an invitation from the mayor to the banquet in my honor.
Ooh.
There's probably some shady shit going down here if Wilson the Kingpin wants JJ. I will, of course, but be on hand personally to present you with an award commemorating your decades of public service the audience and the stories of your good deeds and multitude accomplishments. Sounds great, sir. However, in honor to generate more publicity, possibly for this prestigious event, our office did have an idea. We'd like your newfound friend Spider-Man to attend as well, and to introduce you to on stage.
Yep.
Wilson Fisk wants Spidey, and he's gonna go through JJ to get him. Is anyone surprised by this?
I'm not.
It's certain give you influence and closer association with the wall crawler. He'll be thrilled to oblige. I've even set aside some time for the three of us to have some pictures taken together. Two great New York City mayors and the hero who saved them. Yes, what an evening it will be for all of us. I don't believe it. It's happening. It's actually happening. J. Jonah Jameson is finally getting the respect he deserves. Oh, JJ. Congratulations, Jonah. Congratulations is right. A lifetime achievement award. Even at your age, what an honor. Even at my young age. Yeah, you've done great, Jay. That does not look young. You do not look young, man. And honestly, it looks like he's in love. Yeah, whatever. JJ Loki guy looks like, if I had to guess his age right now, I would say he's probably like in his 50s, maybe 60s with that amount of gray he has, but he looks like he's like in his 40s. It's about, okay, well, Dory, what an honor. It's about time somebody points out how much good I've done for the city, like what I've just been telling you. That Buskins. That Wilson Fisk is a great mayor. Oh my god, JJ, you are backpedaling so hard. Man, could you suck his dick even more? Like, yes. So, really, JJ? Come on, man. Come on. He's like, oh yeah, he's a crook. He's the greatest mayor of all time because he's gonna give me a fucking award. Next page. There we go. A fucking hippo? Just wonder Spidey fight hippos. Taking a cue acrylic, like taking some shots from Batman. Okay, Batman has a massive crocodile. Let's get a hippo instead. Let's get a hippo. So what's his? I'm not even trying to guess. Meanwhile, this is my Christmas. With all the big supervillain attacks in the news, parents have been struggling to find a way to reassure their kids. Let that wet bat back. He's rocking. A toy Galactus. Why are you getting your kid a toy Galactus? Even if it's like looks like a baby, Galactus is still Galactus. You know, the man that eats planets, Galactus. The man that has a Silver Surfer to his building, Galactus. Why are you getting your kid a toy Galactus? Do you not know of Galactus?
Anyway.
So this toy company created a line of dolls to show off the softer sides of all your favorite world-threatening menaces. Okay. Galactus hungers for friendship. Nah, he hungers for planets. He don't hunger for no friendship. He hungers for them planets. He hungers for Earth. He hungers for the Silver Surfer to get him Earth. Feels like a mixed message to me. Right? What's next? You're gonna get, like, the Green Goblin? A friendly, you know, doll? Even though he raped Gwen Stacy and impregnated her with two kids before he killed her? Yeah, that actually happened. That's actually in the comics. I think that's actually still canon, too. Comics! Not as bad as Spider-Man Reign, though! But the things are a hit, like a Tickle Me Elmo level hit. Why was that thing so popular? Everyone was like a few years ago, everyone wanted that stupid thing back in, like, what was that, 2015 when that thing was so popular? God, my shoulder. Which means some parents, or it's eBay spectators, are willing to truly to do truly uncomfortable things to get their hands on one. Like, for instance, hiring monstrous supervillains to steal it for them? What? I know, the irony. Oh my god, what is wrong with you? I thought Black Friday was bad. Like, I'm sure I'm not the only one. You have all seen the crazy shit some people do on Black Friday, and they're like, oh damn you, kill people for those fucking deals. And here, for a toy for a doll Galactus, they are legit hiring fucking hippos to steal them. You couldn't get Kraven to do it? the Chameleon? To sneak in there? You couldn't get the Chameleon to do it? Why are you hiring a massive fucking hippo? This is essentially just a knockoff of Rhino and Killer Croc. And he's stepping on Spidey too. Good. Now he's gonna have back issues like his Spider-Verse counterpart. And well, guess better take care of this. Tis the season, right? Whoa, nice. Webbed him up. And with Hippo out of commission, there goes the dog Galactus. Next page. Hey, Robbie! I can make sure at least one of those dollars end up in the right hands. Here you go, little guy. Aww. Give him back his dog Galactus. Does this kid even know that Galactus destroys, that Galactus eats planets? Okay. Maybe that will help remind some of those people down there who what the holidays are really about. Or not. We'll start the bidding at 200! I hear 250 to... What the hell? Why is this kid over there bidding with this thing? I'm done! I'm done! This kid looks like he's 12 and he's over here! Alright, who wants this? Who wants this dog to let this out here? 300! Go! Do I get 350? Do I get 350? 50, 600! Let's go! Do I get 7? Do I hear 7? 700! Going once, going twice! Sold to the man over there! What the hell? Why is this kid over there bidding on Galactus? Some people still get it. Ho ho ho, happy holidays. Hey, my man Robbie. Nice to see you, brother. Like Brian Robinson here, editor-in-chief of the Daily Bugle, the pillar of the community, and my former boss. That's nice seeing that old design of Peter. I really dig that design of Peter he had back in those earlier issues. Although it looks kind of different there. It looks a little more refined, I guess. I don't know. Dig it. Come on in. Good to see you, Pete. You too, Robbie. Sorry I'm late, but I did bring... That was in the bag, wasn't it? Oh, Peter. You can never catch a break, my friend. Not even on Christmas. That's what MJ is. That's what MJ has something for you, brother. Yee, sorry, Subway was pretty crowded. Next page. Don't sweat it, Mark. Don't sweat it. Martha wants me to stay away from the sweets anyway. Anyhow, seeing I'm getting softer than her favorite pillow. Thanks again for the invite. By the way, I wasn't sure if you really wanted me to see. You really want to see me after. You mean after I fired your ass?
Or he says butt, but I'm just gonna say your ass because it sounds close. But.
Pete, come on, I told you. I know there's more to the story. I believe you there, even if nobody else does. I just have to protect the Bugle. Exactly, but no matter what happens at the office, you're still family here.
Respect.
Speaking of, I just got off the phone with Betty Brandt. She sends her love.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Oh yeah, I recently learned that Betty was actually one of Peter's original girlfriends before he really hit it off with Gwen.
Did not know that, because I always thought she just worked in the Bugle in the Sam Raimi movie. But she was never really in anything else
besides the comics. She was never really in any of the video games TV series.
Really all in the Sam Raimi movies. Anyway, enough of me. She's on a sideman in Europe chasing that big headline. That's her. Lord knows how we could use it right now. Still things dicey at the paper. To say the least, say you don't still keep in touch with any of those big time rich investigators from back when your Parker Industries days, do you? Sadly they don't see to return my calls anymore.
Aw.
Well, I'm sure there's a certain woman at Alias Investigation that I'm sure will help you out there, Robin.
The reason watching Jessica Jones 2, I'm loving that series. It's so good. So good.
Anyway. Sadly, they don't seem to return any of my call to get mine either. Stuff like this isn't helping. Where are the Daily Bugle's J. John Jameson is said to be honored by Mayor Fisk, and Spider-Man is going to be there, I guarantee it.
You heard me, Spider-Man. Jonah wants Spider-Man to present him an award with an award from the Kingpin.
This is why the investigators won't come near the Bugle. Try as I might, we still associate with Jonah's antics. Meanwhile, circulation keeps drowning because don't traffic in his tabloid sensationalism anymore. Because we don't traffic his tabloid sensationalism anymore. It's a loser situation. You not to mention the man, he won't even speak to me. He still believes it's his paper. It's always about himself with Jonah. Jeez, Rob, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. But it reminds me, I'm not gonna be able to stay long as I like. Aunt May needs me to send J. Jonah Jameson straight on some things. Oh no, not you too. Martha is still away visiting her sister. And he's the one, and now this one says he's ditching me for a hot date. Who am I gonna watch It's a Wonderful Life with?
I've actually never seen that movie, actually. It's on my bucket list, because, you know, it's a classic Rickman movie. So it's on my list. I mean, they're probably gonna be airing the shit out of it on TV on Christmas Day, so I can probably catch it once.
This dude's like, hey man! I gotta get some pussy, Bubba, dude! Sorry, Pops, this one's a keeper, and I did waste away all my afternoon in the kitchen on this turkey for you. You're just gonna eat it fast is all.
Oh boy, try. Hey man, good luck on you. Good luck. Hope you get some, my brother.
You hear that, Pete? He's your room. Here's your, who's that girl Randy won't stop talking about? Stop now to, I wish I could tell you, sir. Alright then, knucklehead, seeing as you're so busy, let's make the most of our time together. And this is more like the high spirit family, friends, and...
Next page.
Who the hell is this guy? Arcade Industries.
Tell all you criminal associates and 10% off the through my referral program. But for right now, I trust everything is to your liking and you did the hard hat tour. I did, and I appreciate your attention to detail. Not to mention, it's all my pleasure, actually. Most people in your position, they just don't appreciate a good elaborate death trap anymore. Tastes change, I guess. Who the hell is this dude talking to? And who the hell is this dude in a bow tie? For a second, there almost always MJ for a second. I know it's not Cletus Cassidy, because he's like dead or something in like the Venom book, so I guess this is like Marvel's Tinkerer or a toy. No, the Tinker's Marvel, the Toy Maker is DC. Gotta get my names right. But that's why I'm offering folks like you or yourself the starter package. If you want to up the body count, though, it'll cost you. I understand, but there's only one man I'm after. Now, if you'll excuse me, the part's just about to start.
Ooh, JJ look good in that suit, brother. Ooh, JJ, you look good in that tuxedo over there. And my boy can really freshen up.
Here we are, Jameson. Wonderful boy. Can't wait to see the faces on all those high society century club twats when you see I'm back. That teach them to revoke my membership for poor gym hygiene. That's nice, James. That's nice, Jonah. But was a limo necessary? It's quite an expense. Nonsense. We need to show off in style. Let them know that J. Jonah Jameson is back. You sure are. Next move.
Hey! A man spotted.
Boy, this is just like old days, if you ask me. Spider-Man, where are you? You want? You what? You invited me here, remember, Jonah? Alright, force of habit. That's fine, but we need to talk. I thought they were friends now. I think it's a pretty unusual friendship. Oh, I bet. Next page.
What do you want? Make it quick. We need to get there before all the controlling hogs are hog all the good cashews out.
That's probably some food. I'm not going there. That's what I came here to tell you, Jonah. What? What are you talking about? You owe me, Peter. You owe me, Parker. Hey, keep your voice down with the Parker pay. Oh. I owe you? Are you kidding me? You are darn right you do. I've learned your dirty little secret. Help me, you help. You need me.
I'm out there every day trying to repair your disaster
of a reputation. My, you're the one who's disastered in the first place. My gods, I'm done. I'm doing my best, right? I'm doing my best to make that right,
Jesus.
But you won't even return my calls anymore. We were supposed to be partners. Ugh, Christ, I cannot speak. Look, Joan, I told you, things are a little crazy right now. I need to figure out how these things work. Let me tell you how partnership works, then, kid. When I ask for one measly favor, you come through. I wish I could, JJ, but come on, dude, it's the Kingpin. He's the mayor, besides. I don't know why you'd be so upset about that. I've seen the way you've been cozy up with Fist since he got elected. Why does everyone keep saying that? Next page. Wilson Fisk is a criminal and a monster. For as long as I've been Spider-Man, I've been fighting him. I mean, he's more of a Daredevil villain than anything else in the Spidey, but yeah, you've had your battles with him here and there, but he's a Daredevil villain. How can people think I would ever be on his side? Why do you keep looking behind me? Seriously, if you trust me on one thing, make it this, no matter what he offers me, no matter what he promises, I will never be caught dead standing next to the Pin Kingpin. I hate this guy. That's Photoshop. I love it. He's like, that is Photoshop, that is fake. I never said a photo with the Kingpin, that is Photoshop. Well, too bad. I'm not going to miss a moment in the spotlight over a petty grudge you were nursing. It's high times I was recognized for all my accomplishments, and at least someone sees that. Unbelievable. It's just like Robbie said. It's really always about you. Robbie Robertson, that turncoat? I should have known you were in cahoots with him. That man stole the Bugle from me. The Daily Bugle from me. You gave it to him! And then he turned around and refused to publish my hard-hitting investigations into your criminal activities. Well, too bad! Even though nobody even reads that part of the paper, that paper since I left, he's ungrateful. Just like you. Well, I don't need either of you from here on out. J. Jonah Jameson walks alone. Or he doesn't walk at all. Next page. Oh, she. Webs Jameson, happy holidays from the Enforcer. Ho, ho, ho. Spider-Man, get them! Okay, fine, but not because you told me to. The Enforcers. An old school trio of mob heavies. Mafias who always look like they were robbed the world's lamest costume shop. He's not. I agree with him there. They were some of the first bad guys ever faced as Spider-Man. Oh, nice little tribute to the OGs. All right, next page. I like to think I've come a long way since then. Then again, these days. Everyone's crazy. You missed one! Miss Jameson, get back into the limo. I can't even keep an eye on even myself, apparently. Next page. So yeah, this is how it should. What should be an easy fight gets complicated. Every time I get an upper hand, get this in my ear. Watch out behind you, you're not paying attention. It's starting to get me angry. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry. Jonah, what did you say? Back in the limo. Still tough little hombre, ain't he? Tired of the twerp. Myself, feel like nothing we ever can do puts him down. That's cause you boys are going about this all wrong. Remember, if you can't beat him, join him. Next page. Give him something to mourn. Jonah! This is why I don't want a partner. Oh. Some con Jones on you, Fancy Dan. And not really shooting blanks after all. Next page. Boss wants him alive for the next party. wake up. Just like your lazy generation, sleeping isn't sleeping on the job. Ah, throwbacks Thursday were a mistake. Put yourself together, we need to come up with a plan. You got us into a mess, now you need to get us out. Jonah, I don't think this is this one's my fault. J. Jonah Jameson. Next was Electro? This is your story. And we have flies. Oh, it's Scorpion. Hey, Scorpion. So we got the return of Scorpion. All right. I dig it. Next page. Alright, so next issue we're gonna have Spidey versus Scorpion. That's gonna be pretty interesting issue next month. So yeah, overall, really done this issue. So like I kinda wish MJ was in here. Because you know it's Christmas. Well, seeing like seeing her a little bit here since you know it is Christmas, but yeah. Pretty good issue. Pretty good issue, by just saying to myself. Overall I'll give this one 8 out of 10. So hope you all enjoyed the video. If you like, if you did, subscribe if you're new. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, feel like it. Links in the description box below. And as always, come back for more. See you guys next time.